but not the least, the students. First of all, let me thank the organizers for inviting me here and giving me this wonderful opportunity of this beautiful program. This is a really nostalgic moment for me. You have taken me back to my childhood days when I used to participate in similar programs in my school. And then sometimes as chief guest, as SDM and district magistrate, I used to participate. But that was till 2003. After that I joined various posts at Lucknow and Government of India. And now when I have come back to UP, so this opportunity has come back to me again. And it is definitely a trip down the memory lane. I must thank Father Pento, Aditya also giving me this wonderful opportunity. I was reading about the rich tradition of Agnel charities, and I came to know that led by, it started with Father C. Rodriguez, who was a patriot, a freedom fighter, who came from Goa to Mumbai, where he started this charity. In terms of schools, I knew beforehand the types of schools, Honorable Archbishop talked about it. But then I learned other activities also, the colleges, ITIs, popular techniques, the work it is doing for poor and destitute children. It is really surprising. And it is these organizations which help in the all-round development of children. It is this type of sincere work which bears the strong shoulders that is required for the development of this country. Our country is these days witnessing the demographic dividend. The youth, I think we are one of the youngest countries in the world in terms of average age. So making the shoulders of this youth very strong so that they can take the country forward is very, very important. All-round development of the country, in line with the spirit of this auditorium, which is inaugurated today, the Satrangi, which means the all-round development of the children. Not only they should learn the education, the knowledge which is required, but the other aspects of the personality are very important, which we just witnessed. I will say leadership, sportsmanship, everything is required. But what is required for a cricketer to be built is how to handle defeat. When you play games, we saw now young children, young girls getting this trophy for winning in the football. And when you play sports, you win every day, you lose every day. If you learn how to handle defeat, only then you can enjoy the benefits, the fruits of success. And that is most important. And where we have seen children from all walks of the society, be it poor students, destitute children, or children from the well-to-do families, they are being developed in the best traditions, in the best interests of the country. Since the students are there, I just also wanted them to remember that two words they should always keep in their dictionary. First word, in fact, which I want them to forget. Keep it in the dictionary, but then forget it. Believe that it just does not exist. That word is impossible. So they should know what is the meaning of this word, but also believe that this word does not exist for them. Second word, which they should believe in, is being stupid. They should always try to remain stupid. Now that looks very, very paradox. When I talk about stupidity, I mean the kid, the beautiful, they enjoy life at this stage. So this type of kid should be kept alive among you when you become grown, when you become adult. That time if you keep this kid alive among you, then you will remember that impossible is the word which does not exist. And stupid means you believe that you can achieve everything. And then try to achieve what you want, dream. What you want to achieve, sky is the limit for you. Second thing I wanted about the career option, since we discovered there are children from the class 12. So these days, when I joined, you know, doctor and engineering, were the two career options which were being projected before every child by the parents. But now students get to decide themselves. So there are career options virtually of every type. Look at the television, you will find young girls doing mass communication, oozing out confidence, speaking everywhere. You see the war of Iraq, Afghanistan, you see young girls doing this type of reporting. Everywhere, in every field. I was just remembering when I went to, before this I was DTG of UIDH, and I once went to attend the meetings. So I was just noticing that all 1, 2, 3, my bosses, they were all women. So this is very, very important that we should try to catch our dreams, try to fulfill our dreams. Artificial intelligence, virtual reality, space technologies are the new career options. You don't have to look for being doctors and engineers. Of course, they are also important. We need them also. My parents are teachers. So teachers or gurus are the persons. And we see what type of development these teachers have done, these children. So teaching, different professions are there. Just decide what is your dream, what you enjoy the most. So don't look at the just financial prospectus, because you are not here to become an ATM, a money churning machine, but you are here to fulfill your dreams. Last but not the least, when I have discovered that your shoulders are broad enough, you will definitely take the country forward. I want you to start at home, right at this place, being the CEO of Greater Noida. Let us remember what is our responsibility towards Greater Noida. And why I am saying this to the children, because I find, just like I started, children are the most effective means. The students, if they tell something to their parents, that is, this has to be done. Simple things like each one, teach one. Each one, plant one. When we talk about teacher, if you want to say no to the plastics, in Greater Noida I discovered there is this problem of garbage, so many waste material. But then, if we have to join hands together, then we have to make sure that we properly collect the garbage, don't throw it out, put it in the proper dustbin. All these things, these are small things, but these are the things which make our character. And once our characters are built, then we can build the country. So let us start at home, at our Greater Noida. This is only one of those cities where infrastructure has actually proceeded before the population has moved in. Earlier we see wherever we went, all the cities used to exist and most of the infrastructure is actually being retrofitted. This is a beautiful city, green city, and we have to keep this city as most beautiful and also make the city beautiful as the city happy so that people feel happy. So my request to the students, just don't forget the studies, but enjoy to the fullest. These are your best years. Of course, you have to remember that smile and silence are two most important weapons before you, with you. But then, when you appear for an interview, when you go for a viva, then you have to speak. Communication skills will be the most important. And that is what I just saw, that you have learned all of this. This auditorium, and today's program, Satra, basically symbolizes what actually needs to be achieved. On this occasion, I congratulate everyone, the students, the parents, the teachers, principal of the school, all other associated for getting this beautiful auditorium. And I am sure that this beautiful auditorium will make your life also beautiful. On behalf of authority, I am sure that if anything is to be done, if I can join hands with you in your endeavor, you will find that authority does not lie behind. Thank you very much. Thank you.